What's up, guys? Mike here. We're going to Vegas today. Should be a super fun time. We're driving, we're gonna stop off Salt Lake City, we're gonna have a couple places that we're gonna pop by and take a peek at some spots. So, really looking forward to it. It's gonna be a blast, and I cannot wait to get down there. Playing WCPPL Event 2. Caleb's coming from the Impact camp, so it's gonna be a good time. So we just hit Montana, we just crossed the border, no issues. Caleb's driving now, I'm gonna take a nap here. So as of right now, we should be hitting Las Vegas, the strip, around 11 a.m. if we bomb straight through. Speed limit here in Montana is 130 kilometers an hour. So we should be cruising pretty fine here. Five hours outside of Salt Lake City right now. We just had a ton of rain. I had some snow going on. Took quite a bit of a nap just to refresh here. Caleb's got some coffee. So, we're gonna be good. Gonna cruise straight through. Hopefully we'll catch the sunrise on video here. I think we should be able to. So, it should be a good time. Here we are, somewhere in Arizona, just outside Mesquite. Pretty cool spot. I don't know if you can see the mountains behind me here. Caleb's over there playing with some cactuses, trying not to get stung by or bitten by a snake or a scorpion. It's pretty cool out here, it's gorgeous. We are walking into Vegas Extreme Paintball.
I can go snake side or off the center too.
What place your spot, Ian?
Usually either Logan or Bono. Hey.
So what are you making right here, Caleb?
Making some penne, some gourmet homemade penne with some Prego sauce, and that's it, because that's all we have, and we couldn't find anything else.
Cooking with Mike, 101. Make sure you put your pasta sauce in a pan, and then fire your pasta in there. Heats up quicker. Proven fact. Science. How is it?
Good.
At our hotel, actually it's kind of more of a condo complex. We've got our own hot tub right here, so I've been sitting here crushing beers. Fortunately Caleb can't, not old enough, but I'll drink a couple for him. Hung out with Chris there from Southwest Fury, now Veteran Militia. We used to play together last year. He brought me down to CPPL for the first time, so he introduced me. Super nice guy, super tight, him and his family, great people. But right now, just finished up dinner. Gonna have a couple more in the hot tub and wait for the rest of the boys to get here. So hopefully they're not gonna be too long. Probably have a team meeting and then yeah, we'll go to bed because we gotta be up super early. Game starts at 7 a.m. tomorrow, unfortunately. Team meeting is in a few minutes, so I'll hit this up when we go there. Looking forward to it, meeting all the guys, and I think it's gonna be a good time. So, what do you think, Caleb?
I'm excited for it.
Yeah?
For me, the only guys
too. There you go.
Where you're gonna go god off break? You're gonna go god off break?
No.
Caleb is gonna go god off break.
Yeah.
Is Ian?
Ian.
Logan Bono.
Logan.
What's up? I'm Aaron from Virtue Paintball. How's it going? We're going to talk a little bit about the new Spire 3 right now. This is the new color called the Black Ice. So the Black Spire 3 with the ice windows in it. A lot of cool features on the Spire 3, one of which is that it's got the Spire 3 app. So right there, using your phone, you can update to the newest firmware and configure all your settings wirelessly via Bluetooth, which makes it a really easy way to make sure your settings are right. You got the newest software, and you don't have to remove the board, send it anywhere. So that's one of the cool things. On top of that, it's completely toolless. You can take the whole thing apart just using your hands. Of course, the HST hinge shell technology button right there, and it'll pop open. I'm just gonna go ahead, squeeze on that, pops open like so, and you can see the tray, everything else right there. The tray comes out just like on the original Spire, so you just pull on this little tab, and it's gonna come right out. When you see the tray, you'll notice it comes with an integrated spring ramp. This is also the reload indicator. It's when the hopper's full and the ramp's down, the light up here in the front, which is going to show on this part of the shell right there, is going to be blue. Then, once it's time to reload and the spring comes up, that light's going to turn red. If you want, you can also set it up to audibly tell you it's time to reload via a beep, which is another one of the cool features. If you dislike the beep, all you gotta do, hold the bottom button on the shell 1 second till it beeps, let go, and you've all of a sudden turned off the audible reload indicator. The actual drive cone itself is held on magnetically, so it just pops right off. These fingers right here, super strong, much stronger than the original drive cone, but should it ever need to be replaced, all you gotta do, just peel these off and go ahead and get you a new one right on there. You know, this clips right on there magnetically. The entire thing can be taken apart just with your hands. So you unplug that, pinch on here, those little tabs, get the board off, and all of a sudden you've separated everything without a single tool. A lot easier to clean all the way in the raceway and everything as needed. Notice also that the sensor has a silicone housing. It's going to really make the sensor not take a beating from bad dives, things like that, and it's just going to feed when you want it to. That's most of what's cool about the Spire 3, but another thing that's pretty nifty about it is compared to the original Spire 200, it's going to be the same overall profile as far as height, length, etc. But because we're able to get a 30% smaller motor that's able to feed 30% faster, we were able to lower the tray, put the electronics underneath, and we were able to have a 220 plus pound capacity in the same size shell that used to only hold 200 paintballs even. So, new Spire 3, check out your local paintball dealer today or at virtuepv.com. So amped right now, we're going to Jimmy John's. I love this place.
This is what it's like, right here. Real American grit. Ain't no Donald Trump here. Ain't no fucking Obama. This is just you, me. This is gonna be you and me. I'm done.
Started our trek back to Calgary. We're in southern Utah right now, about 2 hours outside Salt Lake City. The weekend didn't go as planned. We went 0-4. First game, we started off really strong. Then kind of just fell apart and never really picked our socks back up and went from there. It was unfortunate. But it was cool meeting the guys, good group of guys. Definitely a fun experience. The drive is something that probably won't happen again. It's a long one, but it's cool seeing all the different landscapes going through. Idaho, and Utah, and Montana, then a little bit through Arizona, and then down through Nevada there. So I'll let Caleb touch base on how he felt his weekend went.
Yeah, I'm pretty much on the same page.
place or anything, but it was awesome to see what D2 was like and see what the jump is with, you know, communication and all the typical skill levels, like gun skills and everything. Yeah, I definitely loved the experience. That was pretty awesome. Fun trip. Yeah.
Border. It's 6:43 in the morning. We've been driving straight through since, I guess, yesterday at around 2 o'clock in the afternoon, so it's been a long drive, and we've got a couple more hours left until we're home and safe and sound. What do you think?
I'm happy. I'm happy to be home. I'm happy to be going back to my bed.
So we're back, sit at the, fuck.